share it drops for days. Still the people rage.
He's chopping at the bit, if you would, for an opportunity. I don't know who it's going to be. It'd be ridiculous.
Oklahoma City at American Airlines Center for the first time since December 30th, 2018. Brunson in the lane starts the game with a basket for Dallas. At 31 to start this year against Chicago for his season high, Al Horford in the paint. The 14-year vet from Florida, averaging 14 a game, is on the board.
Feel like you got to call him OG Al Horford.
Yes.
I tell you what, as Richardson gets in the lane, tell you what, they play like a team that doesn't have anything to lose. So that puts him in position to be successful. That's a team, Brunson, all the way to the rim with that left hand.
Oklahoma City's won three of their last five games, but their last game was Saturday. And it was a 30-point loss at home to Denver on the second night of a back-to-back. There's an aggressive move by Al Horford to the basket to score. Kleba up top. We just saw him miss a three a moment ago. Number four in the league in three-point percentage. But he gave the ball up to Dorian Finney-Smith, who drives and scores.
One of the problems OKC has is scoring. They're rated last offensively as KP uses his size against a smaller defender from OKC that time. He has size, so he may as well use it.
4-3, second year from Arizona State. Lou Dort rattles it in.
Dort hit a big three.
Then Burt moves it along. Finney Smith for three, no good. Basically there for the rebound after he just had a 2-for-2 trip on the free throw line. And he'll let it fly and hit it.
I want to hear it.
You want to talk about some weird research.
Yeah.
So last year, Lou Dort had 30 points in Game 7 in the playoffs against you. Both teams down in the 30s. OKC 38%, Mavs 33%. Dallas needs one to fall. They haven't been getting the threes to fall, so that's the option. Take it and throw it down, big man. Boomerangs back to him. Oklahoma City has a new 14 to work with. Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, averaging 23 a night, now finds himself on the board.
Oklahoma City is one of those, they're one of those franchises, like the Mavericks, like the Spurs, like the Heat, that when they decide that Tim Hardaway steps into a three-pointer.
To the end of the playoffs as a five seed of the West, and gave Houston all they could handle in the first
round. Prior to that, all the conversation was, we're going to rebuild.
Yep.
Yeah. We're going to rebuild. And they made some moves, as you see, Mr. Brunson. Because in the past, nobody cared.
Right.
Like, hey, you're going to Cleveland. Nobody cared.
No.
They just ship you off.
They average over 14, almost 15 a game. Johnson leaves it to Kleba, who just pushed it up and scored. Mescal on the pass. Stuck underneath, but able to stay after it and score. Kenrich Williams. Mavs are in front by three. Ball on the floor. Brunson hustling after it. Beat the bigger Mike Mescal. Got down on the floor and wins that loose ball for Dallas. Let's see if they can cash in. Richardson, they can.
Today I'm hustling.
Yes.
He's the Rick Ross.
The boss. I like it.
Trip to the line. It's a two-point Dallas advantage.
No, Williams has been effective. He's made a couple of plays for Oklahoma City.
Hardaway blows by the closeout of Roby for the big flush.
Up, up, and up. Higher functioning offense.
Except tonight, unfortunately. Just 1-for-14 from deep. Corner three made there by Kenrich Williams.
Yeah.
Player health and performance, Casey Smith, said he probably needs a game off. He is expected, according to Rick, before the game to participate in everything at All-Star Weekend in Atlanta. Missed by Dort. Run out, slam dunk. Josh Richardson.
Take it to the house. On the road, just in case something like that happens, right? Who knew?
Top of the key, rattled in by Porzingis.
Bang.
Right here in Dallas.
Building down the street.
Yeah, I was there. I was watching.
Horford with the ball. He's the player who fouled Porzingis and put him on the line, and he backs in and scores.
That's this year.
Yes, that is correct.
Well, he played in Atlanta.
Shot by Brunson's on the money. Often automatic for
Jackson. That's the only one he's ever missed in this building. Was that right there?
Not tonight. Mouse in the house here.
Kleba, and the trap closes.
What a great pass that was.
And not quite from game one, but almost a starter since coming into the league with the Clippers for a year and now 2 years in Oklahoma City is Hardaway with a splashdown pull-up. Shai Gilgeous-Alexander steps around Brunson and scores in the paint off the glass. Hardaway Jr.'s 11 off the bench, your top scoring Mavs.
That's nice. Ooh-wee.
Porzingis now with double figures with the very nice move.
His long arms uses him to his advantage.
I don't know, Maxey played him as well as you can play him in that situation.
Mm-hmm.
Boom.
Brunson the jumper off the Kleba screen.
Jalen Brunson, I tell you what, as become one of the better off-the-bench players in this league.
Second basket for him in the game. He's got a team-high 7 rebounds to go with his 4 points.
Ooh-wee.
And there is that smooth move from Gilgeous Alexander. Brunson looking for an excellent finish of his own and a scoop to the hoop, but it bounced off the heel. Baisley inside against Kleba, able to finish through contact, and a timeout now taken by the Mavericks. 11 years in Dallas, 14 years in the NBA for JJ, playing in Spain now.
Yeah, he wasn't drafted.
What? Yeah. Over 800 games and wasn't drafted. Nicely done by Hardaway.
And those guys like that.
Work with the intercept off a Mavs turnover. Recover the ball back, and is the player who ends up scoring when it opens up for him on the drive. And Burke with it. And once again, Burke to the basket. This time opting for the kick out. Oh, and a drought buster.
Michigan to Michigan.
Horford operating off the elbow. Now backing into the paint. Bumps Finney Smith.
Yeah, that's one of his favorite shots. So that jump hook.
That bump caught the attention of Rick Carlisle, who was upset about the no call.
Nice kick.
Finney Smith the drive and a dish to Trey Burke for the corner three.
Terrific play that time by Finney Smith.
Kleba came back in. Finney Smith went out.
Nice pass.
Burke flips it back to Porzingis, and now Dallas is finally finding their sea legs when it comes to shooting threes. With 2:20 left to play in the third quarter. Hasn't been easy to separate, but they are separating, and they're separating more. Richardson, Drano on the three-pointer.
It's been tough sledding. Yep. Shooting the threes this evening. Nice pass.
And Roby upstairs for the dunk. A low lead bounce pass by Gilgeous Alexander. Well done.
And the Thunder aren't going to have 60 by. Oh, maybe they will.
59 on the three made by Shai Gilgeous Alexander. With one last chance to add points to what they've done here in the third quarter. Hardaway, and spacing may matter, but that time Hardaway still able to score. A drive here by Ty Jerome to score with 2.3.
Tough finish.
Throw away here by Hardaway on his baseline drive. Going downhill in attack mode is Isaiah Roby. 8 left on the shot clock. James Johnson goes baseline. Finds Kleba hoisting a three. Hitting a three. The sweet sound of the string music. Deep three, and on the money.
Man.
Porzingis hits the bullseye, and Dallas's lead is 81-64. And then he does that on the other end, towering over everyone in the paint for the defensive rebound. 16 points, 12 boards tonight for Porzingis.
Give it to him.
Three more as he hits bullseye again.
He's just one of those guys that stays focused, man, when you start talking about Mr. Brunson.
Pro.
Yes, he is. Good.
Drive and score, Burke. And shaping up to be an ending with a palindrome score of 87-78. 18 wins, 16 losses is the record for the Mavericks at the All-Star break.